When you're navigating through your Power BI report and you click on one visual and you're really excited to see how it is going to affect the other visuals, and then you click on it and it doesn't do the action you want, right? Maybe you want a filter and it's doing a highlight, or maybe you want the highlight, but it's doing a filter. That is called your edit interactions. My name is Allison Gonzalez. I'm a Microsoft certified trainer, and we're going to dive into Power BI Desktop to show you how you can change and edit those interactions between your visuals. So I have a report here in the Power BI Desktop. And with this, I want to control when I click on certain visuals, how they are going to interact with the other ones. So for example, if I click on this data bar here in 2008, I can see how my other visuals are reacting, right? I can see my matrix visual is filtering it. This profit by countries is filtering it as well. So I can see the data is adjusting. Now, if I click off of that, and let's say I click on a data point in North America on my map, well, then I can see I have a filter that is happening over here on the bar chart. So let's take a look at how we can control that, because I have another visual that I added on to this report, which is called the play axis. Now the play axis is a really cool custom visual. It's essentially a dynamic slicer. So I put in a field of data, a column of data, and it's going to cycle through those options for me. And we can see that right here when we play through that. So now you can see it's cycling through all of the fields that are in that column, all the different countries. I can see how my data is reacting and is moving through that point. Now I want to change how the visuals are interacting. I also want to change a little bit about how that visual is working as well. So opening up my visualization pane, and you can do this with or without on object turned on, going into your formatting, your paintbrush, in your animation settings, you have a few things you should always check out for this visual. Specifically, do you want it to auto start when you turn your report on? Do you want it to loop when you have it playing? And also your time. Now it starts off with 1 second, really quick, right? Hard to see what's going on with our data. I'm gonna move that over to 3000, that's gonna be 3 seconds. So that way it's gonna sit on each data point a little bit longer. Now, the issue that's really at hand here is when I click play, even though it's sitting on the data for a longer amount of time, I can see that for some visuals, I'm getting a filter, but for some, I'm getting what is called a highlight. So a filter is where you're only showing the data related to, in this case, France. I can see France over here, versus a highlight where I can see the portion of the data related to, in this case, France, is highlighted while the rest of the data is still visible. So in order to change how other visuals will interact with the visual you have selected, I have my play axis selected and I'm going to come up to my format ribbon. Now your format ribbon, you can see with that green text, is one that you get only when you have certain elements like a visual selected. So I have my play axis visual selected up in my format ribbon. The very far left button, which I jokingly like to refer to as the place of honor in Microsoft land, we can turn on our edit interactions, which we can see changes how visuals interact when data points are selected. So click to turn edit interactions on. Now notice as soon as I clicked that button, we got some extra little icons up at the top of our visual. Notice too, that some of them only have 2 icons, while that middle icon has 3. Now, depending on the different visual types that you use, you will have the ability to either do a filter or a highlight, but some visuals like the matrix, like a map, like a line chart, there's no way to really do a highlight. And so in that case, your filter will be the only option. You also do have the ability to completely turn off interactions so that visual stays the same no matter what is happening to the visual that you have selected. So in this case, I have my play axis visual selected. So what it's saying is, hey, anytime I'm using this play axis slicer, how do I want the other visuals to respond? So I know that I'm okay with my map zooming in to that country. I like that feature, so I'm going to leave the map alone. I could adjust the highlight, and we can play with that. So let's see what it's going to look like if I change it from a highlight, which is currently showing, to a filter. So now notice that the highlighted portion is the only portion that's now visible. And you can really see the change if you're looking at those numbers down at the bottom, right? If I change that back to highlight, I can see that overall, right, we're over a million. But when we change it down to the filter, boom, we're in a much smaller segment of that. Also, you know what? Let's go ahead. Let's turn off our edit interactions for our matrix visible so that it's always showing all of the numbers all of the time. Now, when you are done making your changes to your edit interactions, you want to make sure you turn it off. And to turn it off again, just a simple click of that button up in your format ribbon. And notice as soon as I clicked back on there, those extra icons disappeared from the top right of all of the visuals. So now let's hit play. Let's see how this goes. And there we go. As we're moving to the next country, the visuals we adjusted, right, with our highlight, we removed the highlight, and so now that bar chart is showing a filter. And our matrix, no matter what is happening in our play axis, the matrix remains the same. So that is edit interactions. It is a very simple feature, but it's a very powerful feature if utilized correctly to make sure that your data is always showing how you want it to show and in the best way possible, depending on each visual and how those interactions are happening. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that way you will get all of the latest and greatest videos as soon as they are coming out here on our channel.